Samar Representative Edgar Sarmiento filed a resolution urging the House Committee on Public Order and Safety to investigate the police's killing of Calbayog City Mayor Ronaldo Aquino. Congressman Sarmiento joins us now on the program. Good morning, sir, and thank you for joining us.
Good morning, Christian. Good morning to your televiewers. Thanks for having me.
Okay, when is this investigation expected to take place by the
House? I'm hoping that it will be scheduled as soon as time possible, Christian, to give justice to the slain father of the city of Calbayog.
Okay, I'd like you to respond to these statements coming from the Philippine National Police. Earlier, we had the spokesman of the PNP on the program. He said that the presence of the police officers on the same bridge with the group of the mayor was just coincidental. They just happened to be there.
I have to stand back on the voices I am hearing from the ground, Christian. That this is a well-planned thing. So sad to note that these are maybe rogue members of the Philippine National Police, an institution I love most. And I'm hoping that justice will be given to him. So again, it's a well-planned thing for me. It's still, I still stand fast that this is indeed an ambush. Reason why, the mayor was mobbing towards the north side of the city to attend the birthday of his son. Suddenly a car, maybe to his left side of the vehicle, suddenly opened up, fired at the mayor, allowing the mayor to respond back. And there was another vehicle near the approach of the bridge that, again, released bullets to the mayor. And good thing, and what cannot be explained, and what I cannot accept are the slain officers happens to be members of the Philippine National Police.
Okay, but of course, the initial investigation or information coming from the PNP, at least on the ground, which was also echoed by PNP Chief Adibold Sinas, was that it was the mayor's group that shot first. But according to you, they were fired at initially.
Reason, again, Christian, I appealed to the president, and I'm very thankful to him, and Secretary Guevara issued a department order allowing the National Bureau of Investigation to take the lead in investigating what really happened, to give justice and for the truth to come out.
But in your case, what was the basis of your statement that it was a case of an ambush?
These were the stories. This was relayed to me by a lot of people at the ground. These are my constituents, Christian. I am their voice here in Congress. It's appropriate for me to relay what is being relayed to me as well. And the reason, again, why I appeal to the National Bureau of Investigation to have an impartial report, because this is the father of the city slain by an officer of the Philippine National Police. Reason why I cannot understand. And again, in this hearing, I have to focus on three relevant laws. This is RA 6975-8551, and the Dangerous Drugs Act, which is RA 9165.
Okay, having heard what the PNP has been saying so far about that incident, do you think somehow the police have prejudged this incident already, pending the results of any investigation for that matter?
I'm hoping that the truth will come out. That is their version. I respect that. That is the institution. It's the Philippine National Police receiving a report as well from the ground. And I'm hoping that the chief PNP will come up also with a thorough investigation on the matter of what really happened. Because again, Christian, this is the father of the city of Calbayog, slain and murdered within the bonds of the city. The people of Calbayog cannot accept this. What happened to a person whose whole intention is for the development of our city? One thing that I have to file right away, a House bill appealing to the Committee on Public Order and Safety to come up with an impartial investigation as well.
How long have you known the mayor, Mayor Aquino?
I have known him way back, even though I was not the public servant. I started serving the public when they elected me in 2016. But way back, we used to see each other again before, and happened to be a good friend as well of my younger brother, Mel, happens to be a former DILG secretary.
Okay, so what kind of person was he? Because it's also important for us to understand what kind of person he was, especially since the PNP earlier said that he was not part of any drug list by the Philippine National Police.
I know that was
one of the speculations being floated before, diba? It was a communist speculation. If someone dies in an alleged shootout, madaling sabihin na involved sa ganito at sa ganyan. But what kind of person was he?
Ito si Christian, si Mayor Ronald, napakasimpleng tao. Kaibigan na kaibigan po ito ng bunso kong kapatid si Mel. No? Way back, ang Calbayog naman, nakikilala lahat ng tao roon. Hindi naman kagaya dito sa Metro Manila na it's a big city. In our city, city of Calbayog, we have the land area and it's one of the most prosperous and developed city in Samar that I can be proud of. But he's a simple man, a good man, a kind-hearted person.
Was he on his last term or running for seeking re-election?
He was on his last term, but we never discussed first what's going to happen come May 2022 because we still have one issue that we have to fight, and this is the pandemic. Mm. So never that we discuss something about politics, rather discussing first what's going to happen on the vaccination. That's why last Friday I called up Secretary Galvez and Dizon and appeal to them as well, where is now the vaccines in Region 8? Because we want the frontliners as well in region and in my city and in my district to be vaccinated as well. So never in my wildest dream had I never realized that a good friend, a brother to me, Mayor Ronaldo Aquino, will die this way.
And why would anyone want to kill him? And in this case, even perhaps make use of the police to do this?
Really, the people in Calbayog knows the reason behind this. It's so sad to know this is about politics, Christian, and there are rogue elements who allow themselves to be used by politicians. And so, it's not the institution, Christian. I love the Philippine National Police. I am there, and I will still love them, no matter what happened to our mayor. But these are something that should never happen again. That's why I'm hoping that on the hearing of the House, everything will be answered appropriately by what really happened to the father of the city. And I'm hoping all the questions being raised by my constituents will be given the proper response and answer, and justice will be given to the family of a brother, the father of the city himself, Christian.
So you think this was politically motivated and that the people in Calbayog City know the reason? What exactly do you mean? Can you give us an idea?
It's a known fact. This is the last, for me, Christian, this is the last remaining frontier, the last bulwark of, let's say, development. We want to prove something that in summer, we can make use of the third largest island of this country, right at the center of the eastern seaboard. And, you know, you can see really the persons at the back of the development. If you can see a place or a local jurisdiction that is developing, you can right away judge the person running this place are a totally knowledgeable person whose whole intention is to develop their place. But if you still belong to the top poorest provinces of the land, what does it reflect? And it's also sad to note, it's about politics, Christian.
Inga, so I hope you could speak more plainly. I'm not asking for names here, but help us understand why anyone would want him killed. If that was the intention of the mayor.
He is, you know, he's been running for so long a time. The opposing, a candidate from an opposing campaign is running. It's a known fact that it's his, the strong leadership. These are the family names that is standing path for development. Aquino, Sarmiento, assisted, of course, by my younger brother, Mel, who's always there for us. And gubernatorial candidates. And if you remove one of the dynamics, it will be easier for someone to just take hold of one place. This whole intention is to develop one place. And that's why at the back of my mind, my constituents in Calbayog knows the real reason why.
Has anyone actually approached you to provide solid information as to why and who actually ordered the killing of the mayor, if that was indeed the case?
So sad to note, Christian, but 2011, please do remember that another mayor, the city of Calbayog, Mayor Ronaldo, was slain as well.
Yeah.
And there was a case build up, no less than by the family of the late Ronaldo Hoy. Names were mentioned, which I cannot state here. I hope you understand. But it's a known fact, Christian. And again, I'm hoping that justice will be given. I don't want to accuse anyone rather than to wait for the report from the National Bureau of Investigation. What really happened to our mayor.
So you want the National Bureau of Investigation to step in? You don't trust the PNP?
It's not that the institution, but again, in this case, Christian, since there is a member of the Philippine National Police, two in fact, who were right away, who were there at the crime scene, whose body were left infra grande delicto. What does it state? No, that's the reason why I have to appeal on the series of killings that we have in Calbayog. I have been consistent with my management or policy in life to write authorities pertinent to the killings, and not one case was solved in all the killings that happened in my place.
Okay.
And this time I have to appeal, and I would like to thank the President and Secretary Guevara for coming up with the order, allowing the National Bureau of Investigation to take the lead.
Okay. Were there members of the team involved in the operation, supposedly by the police? Was there any member of that team that was actually under the local police in Samar or in that particular city?
On the part of the city of Calbayog, there was none, but on the province, there was.
Okay. And what other things somehow that you saw or learned about that incident that raised questions? I understand there was a question regarding the bonnets, right?
Yeah. And then yes, one video. Given. In fact,
go ahead, sir.
Photograph, and there were two. In fact, they were not in the proper attire, as what was stated by due respect to the chief PNP. They wanted to inspect how come you were in bonnet, and these are questions that we want to raise, and these are. There are evidences, there are facts, Christian, which cannot be denied. It's there. These are photographs. And again, so sad to know that the father of the city of Calbayog was slain or was murdered by an element or a rogue element of the Philippine National Police.
Okay. You described it, the team that was involved in that incident, as rogue elements. But that's quite curious because supposedly some of them, if not most of them, were part of the so-called integrity monitoring unit of the Philippine National Police. If that, is the case,
again,
you have a problem here.
Clearly, again, I'm hoping that policies will be set, as what was stated by the spokesperson of the Philippine National Police. They were supposed to inspect different areas of jurisdiction. If ever they will do so, they should be in proper uniform. They should be in proper vehicle as well for them to know, so that people will not judge what really happened. Because in this case, how can people not judge what happened to our mayor? They were not in proper uniform. They were not in the proper vehicles. Why do you have to clandestine your vehicles? Mm-hmm. Why do you have to wear bonnets in this case? Why do you have to bring firearms? High-powered firearms at that, M203. If the intention is just to inspect, if ever you want to inspect also areas pertaining to drugs, there should be somebody from the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency.
Yeah.
The agency tasked pertaining to drugs. It's not the PNP, mind you.
Okay.
That's why I have to focus on three relevant laws to remind the members of the Philippine National Police that we have laws right now that we have to follow.
Okay. Congressman Sarmiento, thank you for joining us on the program, sir.
Thank you so much, Christian, for this opportunity. Good morning, everyone.